VH1's Artist of the Year.
She's awesome in concert.
I love her. She is so cool.
Her songs speak for themselves. It's different.
She's not caught up in the trappings of typical rock and roll.
She seems really fearless in a way.
This woman is it.
There's just this fire coming out of her.
She's nice.
What she says in between songs, that's really her.
This person is really laying it on the line.
She's singing the truth.
And this album isn't a huge departure from the last one in terms of how it will sound. I mean, it's Melissa being Melissa, really.
I make sure I surround myself with good people, with people with good energy, people that work with me.
John Shanks, J-O-H-N-S-H-A-N-K-S. Melissa is, she's a consummate professional. She always gives 110%. She's inspiring. She's got big ears. She really listens. She trusts me to be myself.
I'll buy you mangoes, man. Your favorite fruit.
The experience of recording is just an extension of the way we are live.
Working with Melissa is great fun. I look at it a little bit like how we used to make records in the old days.
Oh, sorry. I'm singing the second verse. Roll back.
She's a real performer.
Okay, Melissa?
Okay, Hugh.
Can you hear me okay?
Yeah. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
So just shout to me if the headphones aren't to your liking.
Cool.
If you want the vocal up a bit or, you know.
I'll let you know.
The usual thing.
Okay.
Okay, here we go.
I really like you. I want to be. I really like you.
I believe what my fans want is for me to be honest. I've never thought of myself as a teacher or a preacher of any kind. I just think I am a mirror and that I am living truthfully every moment, every minute, and writing about it and speaking about it. And I think that's what they want from me.
Brilliant. That's great.
Cool.
She's a great songwriter, you know. She's just... She has the gift.
I don't know if you've got this guitar that you were missing, though.
Yeah, I think so.
In the headphones.
It seemed like I had all the solo ones in the end, yeah.
Yeah?
The overdubbed ones, yeah.
Okay.
I don't think there's a particular concept in this material on the new album. She's just a brilliant songwriter.
I actually need some more... A little bit more voice and guitar, actually.
She's an old soul.
I think my songs, all of them basically come down to love and fear. I have had my own issues with fear, and I have had my own revelations about fear and how it drives this world.
You woke me up.
And I'm constantly trying to figure it out, and I'm constantly writing about it.
Tell me about the fire.
Love and fear are the two. Are the two things that drive the creative force? Absolutely.
People feel like she really is reaching out exactly to them, directly to them. And it's there aren't that many people who can do that.
Everything's coming right from the heart.
She goes all the way in every song that she sings.
She's wonderful.
The openness that she has is probably from her time performing in really small clubs.
She turns all the pain and all the love that she has inside of her into incredible songs. And she delivers them impeccably.
On the truth that seems to haunt me, I'm so engrossed.
I want to make my role models the best at what they do, and she's absolutely the best at what she does.
Life in general, outside of relationships, is full of challenges, is full of pain. You have to feel the pain to grow. And I will constantly, that's what I want to write about. That's what fires my music. That's what keeps that going, both the dark and the light side of life.
As they said in Spinal Tap, we like to have a good time all the time.
Half the first verse and half the second.
Yeah, you know, it's kind of the abridged version. I forgot the Perry Como songs.
If Melissa's taking us someplace, let's say she feels particularly one way or another doing a song, we learn to listen deeper and go with her. So it's really a lot of trust. As we started to work on material for the new album, I couldn't wait.
It's always about the music. I love that.
On stage, she's a typical rocker. Off stage, she's just my friend. Yeah.
That's great.
Cool.
Yeah, well done. That's brilliant.
That's it.
Yeah. Come on in.
I think her mass appeal is the fact that she writes very good, basic rock songs.
So if we do another couple of tracks and then, you know, I can just
take the best.
Yeah.
I still feel like I have so much more to do. I have so much more to accomplish. And there's still so many dreams in front of me, which I think is actually good, because I never would want to stop and say, oh, that's it, I'm done.
Tell me about the fire. Oh,
good, that's good.
When she sings in the studio, every time she sings, it's a performance. And when we're recording these songs, we record them all live with the band and her singing. I mean, it's almost like a sort of a mini gig.
She just comes in and just does her thing.
No drum machines, we have no clicks that anybody's playing to us. Literally, everybody's on the floor. 1, 2, 3, go.
because she's the best.
It's the magical moment where the whole world goes away and it's just me and them, and that's what it's all about.
That's the Walmart and the prison.
She is a big influence on me.
Down by the old VA.
She's one of the great contemporary American songwriters.
And my blue Chevrolet.
I usually put a lot of dynamics into my music. It kind of goes that I wanted this to be all on one level. I wanted it to be about something that was not so clear and definite as usually my songs are. They're very clear. I wanted to dig a little deeper in myself and bring up things that maybe I didn't even know what they were meaning yet.
I love this record.
I think the new album has really strong songs.
I think this is the natural progression of her development as an artist.
It rocks a little bit more than the Yes I Am album did. Power.
Uh-oh, power went down.
We lost the console.
Lost power right there.
The thing that I've always felt with Melissa Etheridge was that we've never been able to truly capture her intensity and the purity of who she is visually.
Shake it right onto camera, come back right to camera. Shake it right back to camera. Shake it right back to camera, terrific. Right
and on this album, I wanted to achieve that. I wanted so much for us to be able to visually interpret the music.
I have no vision. It's all hair. Hair vision. You should call the album Hair Vision.
Visions of hair.
I feel like I was dealt a situation and given chances and opportunities and a talent. And I feel that as long as I love it and it motivates me and I move straight and in search and keep moving, that it will always remain a blessing to me.
More pictures, please. With the satellite dish.
Well, Melissa is a very, very exciting, sensual, erotic kind of woman.
She gets 57 channels with this.
She's an independent kind of woman.
We pick up 3 home shopping networks.
And I've wanted to express a very vibrant, full of fire.
Like one of my songs.
Full of life, full of experience through the images and a strong sense of a woman.
Her energy is so much about live energy, about movement. It's in her hands, her sensuality, the intense attraction people have to her and her music is in her eyes. It's in so much of how she moves and how she presents herself and how she performs that I thought we need to capture that. We need to capture the movement.
Let's have it where you're going to be right about in that area. You're going to be jumping around and the arms and the gritty. Exactly.
I think Melissa's special ingredient is the way that she reaches out and the way that she touches the people. And she really hones in on the different emotional aspects that we all encounter.
Melissa Etheridge is an incredibly strong artist, and she's very sure of who she is.
Exactly, right, that's it. Terrific.
And she is able somehow, which is very difficult and very brave, to be able to do the gamut of emotions, the different places that a person can possibly achieve in a lifetime.
Can you just fix the shirt a bit? Just tuck it out.
That's
great. Thank you very much. I know.
I didn't want to rob Melissa of her movement. And Stephanie seemed to work well with movement.
Here we are in a big fancy recording studio with Melissa Etheridge. And This is Studio A, and we're going to take you into Studio B, where right now history is being made.
It's good mixing the
And the headphones
phones.
Are so, oh, okay.
Fine, just
okay.
Fine.
Jolly good.
Shh, now be very quiet, because we have Hugh Padham and Greg Goldman here fine-tuning art in the making.
You ready to go,
yeah,
then?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Okay.
I wanna find me a car with only one headlight, a straight six Ford on a good luck night. I wanna roll down the windows, teach you to fly. I wanna give you a thrill, the kind you can't buy.
She is very down to earth. I mean, that's, you know, that's all that I've ever seen of her, is just being very real and very comfortable with herself.
And she gives the people those emotions that they want to take themselves to a higher place spiritually, emotionally, psychologically.
Sometimes you feel like if you're an artist, people want you to show them the pretty side of things instead of being too real and too gritty. And when somebody's that real and that honest, it's very inspiring. It really makes you feel like you can do anything.
I've learned it's been a long, hard road, a lot of hard work involved. If you don't really love it, if you don't love every minute of when you get to sing and play, it can be an overwhelming amount of work, and it can start to be a downer. I fortunately do love it and have kept on and have found a way to write and be able to put what I feel and into records and into performances.
So it's just taken some time for everyone to kind of get exposed to her and get hip to her vibe.
I didn't know you'd be here. Okay.
I know what you're thinking, baby.
No, it's quite all right. I would expect you to be wherever I am. Just like you.
And I get asked constantly, you know, you're a woman and it's a predominantly male business.
Oh, that's my call.
I never try to look at it that way. I never try to work from that point of view. I try to, you know, come to people as I am, and that's what it is. When I step outside of it, I like to think that I'm trying to change that. I like the way you look. I know you like me. But I wanna, baby, makes me. When in my show it gets, and it's down and rocking and sweating and we're playing hard and loud, that no one thinks that's unusual for a woman. I don't. Tell it softly to me,
baby. Whether it's a man, whether it's a woman, anybody who's really just giving it their all when they're doing something like that is inspiring to me. You want the lines
of mirror, baby. I feel the same emotions, the same soul, the same rebellion that is rock and roll. I always related to it as a teenager. Now, I never felt that it was different for women than it is men. And I like to play rock and roll and rock out.
She's like a platform from the earth, and the earth's power just comes right out of her.
I think Melissa's very honest, and it affects people's hearts.
I remember when I first heard Bruce Springsteen in the 70s, and he had that just thing. He's like, he couldn't be anything other than American, and I think that's how I sort of sum up Melissa.
I think we could all relate to her. Her music is so sensual.
People really find something in their lives or something in her music that they can relate to their lives.
To be that vulnerable and take as many risks as she does lyrically is who she really is.
That's great.
Cool.
Yeah, well done, well done. That's brilliant.
That's it.
Yeah. Come on in.
Great.
When something touched my skin, I won't ask you to leave here anymore.
Music is only a reflection. And it's the kind of reflection that some people don't want to see. And it's the reflection of change. It's the reflection of rebellion. I, as a writer, just speak over and over about what I see. And the more you say it and the more it's out there, the more it seeps into the collective consciousness, the more it becomes fact. And with that sort of recognizing and acceptance comes change.